Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be using a resource from the Design Class website and we're going to use it to learn about desktop publishing features. We're going to pick out some of the different features that you might find on a magazine spread, a poster or an item of digital media. Starting with our title text, this is usually the largest item of text on the page and it gives an indication of what our article or our item is all about. Our body text is the main text used within an item of desktop publishing. In this case, it's been arranged into columns to make the text a little bit more manageable to read by shortening the lengths of the lines. All of these columns have been left aligned, so you can see each of the lines starts on the left hand side. Text can be arranged in different ways, and in this case they've used a text wrap effect where they have wrapped the text around this image. What this means is the text flows around the edge of the image so it doesn't overlap it. This is a good way of creating unity because it shows that the text is actually moving out of the way of the image and it's shown that both of these things are important. This image also has a drop shadow effect, another good way of creating depth in a layout. This little shadowing effect gives that 3D effect on the object. This image bleeds beyond the edge of the page. What this means is the image extends beyond the boundary of page, giving this impression that it continues beyond what we can see. In terms of the structure of the page, this is a double page magazine layout, so we can see a centre fold down the middle. We can see a margin area around the edge of the page, making sure that none of the important text or information goes into this margin area to avoid it being trimmed off in the printer process. Because the text is aligned into columns, we have a gutter space in between. And in some cases you can see that some of these lines of text run into separate little words. So this line continues and leaves what we call an orphan word, which is stray and sits on its own. There are other elements, things like depth of field, which is a photography term to show that images can blur as they get further away, and it gives another impression that there is depth and that we are looking at something more three-dimensional. As we move into our next part of the layout, we can see another range of different effects. Things like registration marks and crop marks are terms that we learn more about at Higher, but these are all to do with how a page is printed. So for example, the crop marks are where the page would be trimmed and the registration marks align different printing plates. Flow text along a path is often confused with text wrap. Whereas text wrap is something wrapping around an image, flow text along a path is where text follows along a set shape or line. In this case, the lines of text are following a circular path. Copy and paste is something you might already be familiar with, and that's where an item is copied to make a duplicate and then pasted to repeat the item. In this case, it's created a bit of repetition and rhythm, and because these little groups of items are repeated, we get a sense of unity throughout. Typeface is a really important graphic feature, and in this case we have an edited typeface where you can see some graphic elements have been added to make it look as though the text is melting. These small quick shapes are great ways of adding different shape elements and creating more visual interest in your page. So again, the repetition of the circle throughout is a great way of creating visual interest. Images can be rotated to break the kind of grid structure and alignment that you might expect. And layers can also be used to stack up items to create this sense of depth. A header is an item or piece of text in a graphic that sits within the header space. The header space is a narrow area at the top which repeats on each page, and usually you would find the name of the publication or a chapter title sitting in the header space. The footer space is the space at the bottom margin. This is where you might find a folio which would include the page number or even dates and times. Whilst we've previously looked at titles and headings, a subheading is a title or highlighted block of text which is under the main title, and this usually gives an impact statement. So for example, in a newspaper you may see your headline and then you would see a smaller subheading which gives a bit of information additional to the headline. This is quite a lengthy subheading, but it gives a good idea of what we're looking for. Bullet points are small marks again designed to lead you through different points and break up text. We mentioned previously that lots of text is left aligned, and we can see that in these columns here. But right alignment is when all the words are aligned to the right hand side. In this case, this has been done to what we call a pull quote. This is a part of the body text that has been taken out, copied, pasted, enlarged, and in this case changed colour to create a bit of emphasis on that piece of text, and again give the reader a snapshot of the information contained in the body text. Drop caps are large text items where the first letter of a word has been enlarged. This indicates the start of any body text and is a great way of allowing the reader to follow the layout. In this case, this drop cap has been colour matched with the larger text. You can see the repetition of this blue colour in the header space, as part of the title, as part of the drop cap, and as part of this shape in the corner, has been designed in the same colour to create unity. Within this banner at the side, what we can see is a square cropped image. Now, this is a normal image that has been cropped into a square shape, when a lot of images might be rectangular. However, we can also fully crop images, removing the background to allow them to be placed onto other backgrounds, or in this case, a simple white background. Part of this image has also had transparency applied to it. This is where an image is faded out, or a shape is faded out, again to give a sense of depth or create visual interest. All of these different design features, these desktop publishing features, are important for your learning, and it's important that you can identify what they are, why they've been used, and then plan to use them in your own graphic layouts.